Are we even building in the right spots? If things get up, are we building in the highest traffic areas?
The Rio Grande Valley sector is actually the highest traffic sector right now. We are building in some important high traffic spots in the Rio Grande Valley sector.
Good to hear.
And I would add this, too. The fact that, let's say the president gets 300 miles and the courts go on his side, as they should, with all of these legal challenges, that's good. It doesn't solve the problem. Because think of the border as a giant leaky hose.
Sure.
We've got 100 leaks. Well, maybe with this spending, we'll patch 30 of them.
Okay.
That means that we have fewer places now where the drug smugglers and alien smugglers can go through. And I'll say a positive note about the bollard fencing. So I was just down in Arizona, as I mentioned. We were up on the Montezuma Pass at one point, which is a sort of a mountain pass right on the border. And on the east side of the pass, it was about 10, 15 miles of bollard fencing.
Yeah.
On the west side, wide open. And we talked to Border Patrol officers too. The east side of the pass is pretty secure. The Border Patrol doesn't need to spend much in the way of resources and time and vehicles on the east side because they've got that giant 18-foot bollard fence. The smuggling goes on the west side because there is no significant fencing there.
Wow.
And so what it does, the bollard fencing does seem to work. It does force the smugglers to use the open corridors. And it's pretty imposing. It's 18 feet tall. You have the steel bollards, but then at the top, the top 4 feet is a solid steel panel.
Yes.
So you can't just shimmy up and hop over the top. I think they like it because they have seen that it works. So I'm not deeply disappointed that we are stuck with that. It's a decent model that works and has been proven effective.